Hello friends, let's see the another problem on the trusses. This problem is quite interesting, so please listen carefully till the end. So let's see in details problem number 4 on trusses. Now see friends, this is the question given to us. Analyze the pin jointed frame by flexibility method. AE is equal to constant means, now see here, just start the solution, then you will get what the changes is here in this problem. Our first step is degree of indeterminacy. Degree of static indeterminacy. Okay, first we have to check degree of static indeterminacy. The first one will be DSE is nothing but R minus 3. Now see friends, please listen carefully here. See this is also a hinge, and this one is also a hinge. So this is 2 and this is 2. 2 plus 2, 4. 4 minus 3 is equal to 1. Here the DSE will become 1. This is the first problem, that DSE will be 1. And DSI will be M minus 2J minus 3 is equal to, member will be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. 9 minus 2 into joint will be 6. Minus 3, 9 minus 12 minus 3, 9 minus 9 is equal to 0. Here DS will be 1 plus 0 equal to 1, means our DS will be 1, means our external indeterminacy will be 1, means now we don't want to remove the members, now we have to remove this reactions. Either we will remove VA or this VB, so write it the name A. Okay, now we have to remove this. So how will you remove this? See, write it over here. Now we have to remove the forces. So selecting redundant force R means, let R will be HE. So we are removing this HE value now over here. Now convert hinge into roller. Convert hinge into roller. Now draw the diagram and find the reactions. Or you can write P analysis. Draw the diagram over here. Now see, this is will get hinged now and this will get converted into roller. So this reaction will come like this and here will come like this, and this here come will be like this. Okay, so now here will given the load. This is 20 kilonewton and here is 40 kilonewton. This is 4 meter, 3 meter, 3 meter, 3 meter, and F, E, D, C, B, A. Okay friends, now we will remove this HE in horizontal and apply it as a, consider as a roller. Now let's find the reaction now. Taking moment at A equal to 0. Taking moment at A equal to 0, clockwise positive. Okay, clockwise positive. So see, we are taking moment at A here, so we will write, see, this 20 is going in this clockwise direction, means 20 into 3 plus 20 into 3. After that, this 40 is also going in clockwise direction, means plus 40 into, distance will be 4, 5, 6, 7. 40 into 7 minus VE into 7 equal to 0. Here VE will come 48.57 kilonewton upward. This will be, VE will be 48.57 kilonewton friends. Okay. Now after that, see, summation FY equal to 0 upward positive. So this VA is going upward, and this is HA. VA is going upward, so we will write VA minus 40 plus 48.57 equal to 0. Here the answer will come VA is equal to 8.57 kilonewton in downward direction, friends, because it will get minus. So VA will be 8.57 kilonewton in downward direction. So means now we have to change over here is A will be downward, so we will convert it over here. 8.57. Now see, 48.57 minus 8.57 get 40 is going upward and 40 is going from upward and is from downward. So balance now. After that, let's start with the P analysis and first solve, find the forces directly, which is shortcuts. See, this is 20 going in this direction. So this is like this, 20 away from each other means compression. There is no load, we directly get 0 over here. Here also 40 is going in this direction, so it will directly come 40 in compression. There is no load, this is directly get 0 over here. Now since there is no load over here, therefore it will also get directly 0. Now we will find this joint A and joint E. We got the value of AC and AF, EF and EC. Now first take the joint A. Take the joint A. Draw the FBD part of joint A. This is our joint A. What is the value we know? We know this value first. This downward value. Downward value will be 8.57. And we know this value also. This is 20. And we don't know this value over here. This value we don't know. And this value also we don't know. Okay. So you will write like this. This is P analysis, PAC, this is PAF, okay. So here you will resolve in two parts, PAC cos theta, PAC sin theta. Now we have to find this theta. So tan theta is equal to opposite upon adjacent. Opposite will be 3, adjacent will be 4, 3 by 4. So theta will come over here is 36.86 degree, okay. 36.86 degree. So apply a condition of equilibrium. First we have to apply summation fy equal to 0 upward positive. So this is just going downward, so minus 8.57, this is going upward, plus PAC sine 36.86 is equal to 0. So here we got the value of PAC will be 14.28 kilonewton. 14.28 kilonewton is coming positive, means it is a tension. After that, summation fx equal to 0, this has positive. So this PA is going in this direction. So PAF, this is going in this direction, minus 20, plus this PAC will get plus value only. So 14.28 cos 36.86 is equal to 0, okay, is equal to 0. So here PAF will be 8.57 kilonewton, means positive is nothing but tension. Okay, now put this value in this P analysis like this. This PAC will be 14.28, AC will be 14.28, tension means two arrows are kissing each other, 14.28. Here also two arrows are kissing each other means tension, the value will be 8.57. Since this is tension, this is also get tension. See friends, how will you transfer the load? See, this arrow is going this direction. To balance this, we have to apply this arrow into this direction. Opposite of this is comes over here. This is also 8.57. This is also 8.57. Now take the joint E. Now friends, we have done with joint A. Now we have to find this value. So you will take joint E and apply the condition of equilibrium at joint E and you get the E and C part also. So joint E. Now first take the FBD of joint, draw the FBD of joint E like this. Always draw the diagram very neat and clean that you can get understand better in exam. Now we are finding this value. This is PEC. Since this is theta, we will do. Now we know this value. Now see friends, we know these all these values. See, always remember, see, when we are taking joint E, you have to remember this first part. This is going in this direction, this is going in downward direction. So this is going in this and this is downward direction. Now apply the, now see here, see friends, here the distance will be 3 meter, 3 meter, theta will be changed over here. So theta will be tan theta is equal to opposite upon adjacent means 3 by 3. So theta is equal to 45 degree comes over here. So don't write directly 36.86 will here also, because their distance will be 4 into 3. Here will be 3 into 3. So 45 over here. Now let's start the condition of summation. What do you apply first? Summation fy equal to 0 upward positive. Upward positive. So it will get 48.57 minus 40 plus PEC sine 45 is equal to 0. Okay, so here directly PEC will get is minus 12.11 kilonewton. Minus sign indicates that 12.11 kilonewton is in the compression sign. Okay, so now PE, we got the PEC, we no need to find FX also. 12.11 compression means two arrows are away from each other. So you will draw like this. Okay, so this will come as value will be 12.11. okay friends, now we have done all the values of P analysis. Now let's start with the K analysis. Okay, now K analysis will be, now see friends, now friends, see, now what you have to do is, now here this is we are removing the HA. So when we are removing, apply 1 kilonewton over here, we are removing this one. So see, this is going in this direction. So to balance this, this will go in this direction. This is also 1 kilonewton here also, like this. And here also this. Okay, now rest of the value will be 0 because there is no force over here. See, this is going in this direction. Now to oppose this, this will go in this direction. So oppose this, this will got this value over here. Now we have to draw the table to get the better understand. So let's draw the table now. See friends, this is a table given to us. Now draw the diagram. Now draw the table and put all the values AB. P analysis, take the member AB will be 0. We will write 0. And B and C will be 20. Compression means minus 20. I am writing all the values. You will write while seeing the P analysis. K analysis, CT is the K analysis. All the values are 0, only two values are 1, this 1 and 1. All the values, rest of the values are 0. Okay friends, now L will be 3, 4, 3, 3, 3, 4, 5, 4.24, and this is 3. This 4.44 is inclination of 3 and 4. And this 5 will be inclination of 4 and 3, and this will be 3 and 3 inclination. Okay, PKL will be 0 0 0 0, 25.71, 34.28, and 0 0 0. After that, R formula will be summation. This will be summation 59.99 and this will be 7. Okay, so our formula will be R is equal to minus summation PKL upon AE upon summation K square L upon AE is the formula. So minus 60 upon 7 is equal to minus 8.57. Okay, so R will be 8.57. All the R values are same, so you will write like this, 8.57. after the RK will be 0 minus 20, 0 minus 40, 0, 0, 14.28 minus 12.11 and 0. Now friends, see here we got the value of R. R is equal to that, see, that is minus 8.57 kilonewton. Okay, means our HE will be, minus sign indicates that 8.57 coming in this direction. Okay, so actual HA will be 20 minus 8.57 is equal to, HA will be 11.43 is our actual HA, and this is our final answer. Okay friends, so I am reminding you this once again. Now in these types of problems, the remaining, the you have to see this part. So this is important, this both end are hinged. So convert one into roller. After that, DSE and DSI will get checked, and then PNLSS, find all the forces applying the joints, whatever is necessary. Then at KNLSS, this is 1 kilonewton, this is one, and this is one, rest the value will be 0. After that, they draw the table, then find the actual R like this, and this is our final answer. I hope you understand all the videos of the trusses, and yes, don't forget to share with your friends to get the better knowledge. Thank you so much.